when you say the fastest pursuits are always going to be what you say is off the clock.
Right.
Does that make sense?
Yes.
So, pursuits and the fastest pursuits. Fast as I've been in a car, it's hard to tell. Between 155 and 164, somewhere in that gap. The reason it's somewhere in that gap is because one of them were in the BMW where it had gone off and they meant to be regulated, so it wouldn't go any further. So you're having to rely on either what it says on your camera, like on your GPS, a bit on your camera, but you know you're over a certain limit anyway. And the other one's in a VXR, where we are with Mr. Epton, see if you're watching, hi. Where we was going down the M606 in Bradford, and it was up to 157, 58, something like that. And it had gone, it wouldn't really go any further, but we've got VASCAR in, which is a digital system, and VASCAR were going up, but that one won't. So it's like a bit of a, you're just guesstimating then, oh look, it flashed onto this, it flashed onto that, but when you're at speed as well, you're starting to get a little bit of tunnel vision where the things are, you're not looking at that way, but things are pointing when they're coming past you, so the road's getting thinner because your eyes are like struggling to keep up a little bit. There were a pursuit coming on M62 at that point, and we'd overcooked his brake, so as we're slowing down, we're coming off at roundabout on 62, and I put my front brake on Vectra, and it went, do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do, and there's no, literally, brake pads are going, they're overheating, so your foot's going right to the floor, and you've got no brakes. And you're like, fucking hell, I'm still like 130 miles. Do, 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 do. And you're thinking, I'm not stopping here. I'm literally not stopping. And as we come down to the roundabout, Ross like, go, go. Can you anchor it one way, anchor it over. Go around about a bomb at M606. And then they say, yeah, pursuit's now. It's left, 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 slip road. Coming down to the roundabout. And it looks up like pursuit's coming towards us. And we come straight out in front of pursuit. Pursuit goes around back of us. And we're like, and we have to go down this slip road. And then, because brakes are gone, so when everyone's like having this pursuit, they're all sat there with stingers, and we literally come out in front of pursuit, but we come sideways, and we completely miss it because we're too fast. And we end up going down, I think it's A59, whatever it's called, past Greg's, and pursuit goes around and run back, and we've got to like turn around and get on back of it. The fastest pursuits are always in the... It doesn't matter if you're on a motorway when you're pursuing some 150 mile an hour. You might as well be on a runway at 250 mile an hour. Speed's relative, so if you're in a Bugatti Veyron at 250 miles an hour on an autobahn, it's not really fast. But if you're in a Bugatti Veyron in Leeds City Centre at 4 in the afternoon at 120 mile an hour, that's fast because you're seeing what's coming past you at all times. The RS5 on Keith Road, that was stupidly quick because we're in the 30 zone there. In regards to one of the fastest ones that I've had, constant speed, there was an Audi that had been stolen in Bradford, but it was in Manchester, and it had come from Manchester on the motorway, M62, and me and my oppo John said, let's go out, get this, we'll go have a play. So we got to the bottom of the M606, and we got told it was failing to stop for GMP, and it got to over 130 mile an hour, and GMP have decided we need to abort, so they've aborted. And we were trying to figure out distance, time, speed, and sat on his phones, I looked up like that. So I don't know how fast it had come from Manchester and when they'd aborted, but we're like, fucking trying to get his phones out and getting it in pocket and getting the car started. Went up 606, and I think we were 140 up 606, somewhere around there. But I don't look, I'm driving at this time. But at the time, it's winter, I think it's January, there's snow on the floor, it's one of those nights where it's frost everywhere. We get down through into Bradford City Centre, and it's so quick for roads. Not as in like it's a fast car, I think it's just a 2 litre turbo diesel. But it's just so quick, he's driving, he's hitting bends at a 30 mile an hour bend, is hitting at 70, is hitting curb, his car skidding side, and it rather when you've got time to contemplate and you sit into it and you get comfortable, it's not so much like that. It's all like everything's quick left, quick right. We're chasing all the way down through Bradford, up Thornton Road, hit a red light at Thornton Road, I think about 110, and then we got behind him, he's coming towards Roadsway, this little estate, and he starts fucking up then. He's just, I think he's lost his bottle, starts hitting loads of curbs. And this is what gets me about people. You've come all the way from Manchester at such a high speed. You've come all the way through Bradford, such a fast speed. You've got to Thornton Road and you've gone a red light at Thornton Road. You've got on roadsway and then you look at a gap, your car's 5.5 foot and you look at a gap that's 4 foot. Are you that stupid? Are you that stupid? Rather than just staying up road, I'm going to go for gap. You can see his mate going, what are you doing going for gap? I'm going for gap. Don't go for gap, your car's not going, going for gap. So he goes for gap and literally within 2 seconds, car's on its side, stuck between a lamppost and a tree. And it's literally on its side there and it's still stuck in car. And it was somewhat like of A-Team. It was like, it gone, buff, 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 buff. And wheel still going round. And they sat there and they must have gone, fuck. How the fuck have we done this? So like we all swamped car and we're all looking at him through, what are you doing? Turn it off, get out, lock them up. That's one. But what you've got to look at as well is pursuits. Over the last 15, 20 years, pursuits dynamics have changed. Before we didn't used to have cameras in car. Then we went to having cameras in car with IH tapes, with its little tape in car that used to have Ryan. Then we went on to, and we never had sound switched on. So it was like, oh, putting sound on pursuit. No, don't put sound on. And then it's like, it's gone from then to the car's automatic recording when you put lights on, then the body cam not looks in with car. So your professionalism has have to got through is so quick. So when it first started out, you'd be in your T5 chasing all these people. And you're like, shall we put it on? No, turn the mic off. So you're literally like, what's 2-3, vehicle failing to stop. Yeah, passes directions. Yeah, we're North Street at Keighley. And as soon as you let the radio out, you go, fucking ram him, take him out, chase him. And all these like words that you can't say in a pursuit would be coming out. Yeah, he's going left, fucking hell, he's nearly that. Yeah, we are now still Bradford Road at Keighley. We are heading towards the roundabout. Fucking hell, do you see that? And all those days are sort of like gone, because the more you watched, the more driver training have got to look at your footage, the more you put over, how can I put it, your arse is put over fire. So you've got to do stuff professionally. And the lot are in my career, you had to do it all the time. So if you just think about this on a fast pursuit, you might drive. When people say they drive fast, they don't drive fast. People drive fast on racetracks, which is fine, but the only people that drive fast on the roads, and I don't care about your mate who's got an RS3 that goes 150 mile out motorway, that is not driving fast. That is being on the right road, the right size road for that sort of car. But to do it in a city centre with people about and that sort of thing, they're the people. So they're either firearms or traffic cops or criminals, proper criminals that are hell-bent on getting away. You can't rewrite this feeling, you can't know this feeling until you've been in it. So you imagine going now on a 30-mile-an-hour limit at 100-mile-an-hour. At 4 o'clock with people stepping out, you've got to drive that, and I'm excited saying, watch him, watch her, watch this, watch that, do that, look at your speed. So you imagine doing that. Then you imagine watching what that driver's doing. You're also driving about yourself, but you're watching what the driver's doing, and you've got to analyse how dangerous it is in a scale going up and down. So you know, like on Terminator, when it's all red and go beep, 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 and you've got all these graphics going outside, it's a bit like that. You're trying to fathom out what's going on with him, drive, but you're also having to feel what your vehicle's doing. Is it twitchy? Is it not twitchy? Is it this? But I'm also looking at Mrs. Miggins, going around Mrs. Miggins, but I'm watching Bandit Driver and I'm analysing what he's doing. Not only doing that, I've got my finger on stalk and I'm having to give comms of where I'm going. So I'm now left, 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 canal road, right, 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 so and so. Watching him, feeling what my car's doing, watches Mrs. Miggins driving 100 mile on the 30 zone. Now, not only that, on top of that, I've got to formulate a plan. So, 1-2, where are you? I'm at Lace that junction, 1-3, where are you, so-and-so. Right, M-Pass is coming. So now I've got to formulate a plan of all the officers that are coming to the scene, because I'm ground commander, figuring out where they're going and what plan I'm going to put in place, where I'm going to put a stinger, where I'm going to do box, where I'm going to do this. What's my car twitching like I'm 100 mile an hour in a 30 zone? What's Mrs. Miggins doing? What's his car doing? And then you might have someone sat aside you like a probationer. And when you look round, you're like, oh yeah, 100 mile an hour, we saw left, left, left. Can I have my next unit that comes and turn around? And they sat there and they're... And you're like, come on, can you give me an hand? And I've been there. And there's been one or two bobbies like Matt, one of the lads who, again, one of the best of warrior pursuit driving. When you're in passenger seat, you used to go down, click handle off. So if I'm with a pursuit specialist in car, I'll drive and they'll do comms. So it's taking that pressure off you as a driver. So you think about how pressured it is already, you've got to bring that down. So I could get on, yeah, Matt's driving, yeah, we are now left, left, left. And then Matt knows commentary's right. So when me and Baby Ben did it, and me and John did it, it was we had a flawless thing between us. Matt's done it where it's like a phone, hear, mouth, lead. They've got it upside down. So they've got the hearing bit there, the phone bit here, and the wire dangling down, and they wonder why they can't get any reception. They've got the mouth bit to the ear. They've got the ear bit to the mouth. They're not turning it on. And Matt's like having a pursuit, and Matt's just look and then puts her hand down. Still at 110 mile an hour in a 30 zone, thinking about his own vehicle, thinking about what Missing Biggin's doing. Where's his mates? Doing comms. And he's also now looking at his probationary. Put that down. Don't touch that again. Do not touch that again. How can you be so calm? That's the difference. So that's what makes the fast pursuit. It's how fast you are analysing to how fast your vehicle's going to what they're doing. So as I said before, if they're getting to the point of being so dangerous and you're thinking what Mason Miggins doing and your oppo's doing, your comms and you don't have enough units, that's when you're bought. And that's what makes a fast pursuit.